Assalamu alaikum. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, along with his wife Hajar radiallahu anha and their son, they head south to Mecca, a desert, no living being is around. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam, once he arrived, gave her some water and some dates, and he did a U-turn and went back. What about your wife? What about your son?
AlMaghrib Institute presents Q&A with Majed Mahmoud.
So Hajar radiallahu anha, she tells her husband Ibrahim, Ya Ibrahim, ila man tatrukuna? Oh Ibrahim, to whom are you leaving us? She knows he's a human being and she knows he's a prophet. So she just wanted to confirm, because it's not logical that you're leaving us in the desert. It's just a matter of time till we die out of thirst and out of hunger, because this water will eventually go away and this food will eventually vanish. It's just a matter of time. But Ibrahim alayhi salam was not answering. So then she asks Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allahu amaraka bihada? O Prophet Ibrahim, did Allah command you to drop me here with my son? Then he says, Na'am, yes. Then Hajar radiallahu anha, look to what she says, إِذَنْ لَنْ يُضَيِّعَنَا, then Allah will never forsake us, Allah will never neglect us. And she also said, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ, I am pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened? She didn't leave the desert. Nothing changed. The command is the same. You're staying here in the desert. But what she saw and she kept her mind focused on is the commander. The commander. If it's Allah who said to do that, then I am more comfortable. Yes, it's going to be difficult. Yes, it will be tough, but I know for a fact that it will always be good. You see that mind shift that just happened to Hajar? She was panicking. Ibrahim, who are you leaving us with? What's going on? You know, this is pretty much pretty bad. Oh, Allah said that? Okay, I'm good. Allahu Akbar. So that's how we should view obligations, brothers and sisters. Oh, I wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning to pray Fajr. That's a 5 to 6 hour of sleep. That's khair for you, that's good. Oh, I need to go pay zakah from the hard, you know, earning money that I get. Yes, you will not see poverty and you will not struggle, inshallah, because of your zakah. Allahu Akbar. You appreciate that and you become, ya Allah, like Fatima bint Qais. What happened? Fatima bint Qais, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he received a question from her. Then he advised her on what she needs to do. But Fatima bint Qais, when she heard that from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she kind of like saw like, are you sure? Like, I need to do the advice that you just told me? Because to Fatima didn't kind of make a lot of logic to her. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ta'atullahi wa ta'atu rasulihi khayrun laki. Allahu Akbar. I love this, by the way. This year, 2021, I'm recording this. This is one of the best statements I've learned in this year. That was, obeying Allah and obeying the Prophet of Allah is good for you. Ya Allah, it's beautiful. Wallahi, just keep this in your mind. Everything that you do, that Allah said for you to do, will always be good for you. Khalas, that's it, it's done, it's over. So when Hajar had this mentality, Allah said that, it's khair. It'll be tough, it'll be striving, struggling. But Allah said that, inshallah, nothing but good will come out of it. Go back to Fatima bint Qais. Fatima bint Qais, she says, so I married that man. It was a marriage advice the Prophet ﷺ gave her. So she married that man, and look to what she said. فَغْتَبَطُّ, like people saw my marriage as a model. Like, I wish every marriage is like Fatima bint Qais, and so subhanAllah, and they were so impressed by that. And you see the khair in the dunya in addition to the akhirah.